Hello and congratulations to making it to the Massachusetts State Championship. You have all worked immensely hard to be here and should be proud of yourselves and teammates for what you have accomplished. I'm David Nguyen and I once sat in the same seats as you all. Devin Wayne asked me here to talk about my first experience and how it helped shape my career. I started in FLL as a fourth grader and then moved to FTC in high school. I'm currently a fifth year mechanical engineering student at Northeastern University, working in robotics and mechatronics. I also work for 3 6-month periods through Northeastern's co-op program at full-time companies. My proudest accomplishment so far has been winning $1 million for Northeastern as part of their ANA Avatar X Prize team last November. This all started when, as a freshman, I used my FTC experience to convince Professor Peter Whitney to take me on as an undergraduate researcher in his lab, part of the Northeastern Institute for Experiential Robotics. Professor Whitney's research focuses on using novel hydraulic actuators to make robots lighter and smarter using haptic information. The ANA Avatar X Prize competition started in 2018 with $10 million in prize money, with a focus of developing physical robot avatar systems that can transport your senses, action, and presence to a remote location in real time and feel as if you're really there. While doing research in the robotics lab, I developed an exoskeleton glove that allowed an operator to feel different textures and interact with the world. In the last few months leading up to the final competition in November of 2022, our small team had to add full haptic exoskeleton arms, a wheel base, full remote control, and as you know, spent countless hours integrating and tuning the whole thing. The actual competition involved independent judges who operated each team's robot to accomplish a variety of tasks. Finally, after surviving several 14-hour days and recovering from some disappointment, we emerged as the third-place finisher, winning the $1 million. From my work at companies and in the research lab, I realized the amount I had learned from my first robotics experience beyond just the technical robotics skills. It might be hard to see at first, but everything that you are learning, even down to the judging presentations that you all make, helps prepare you for the engineering world ahead. Time management, adaptability, leadership, creativity, and problem solving are just a few of the skills that you are learning through these competitions. Most important of which is problem solving. In real life, problems don't just have a single correct answer. Instead, there are often many ways to solve a problem, each with their own pros and cons, and the important skill is in evaluating the solutions fairly and choosing the one that is most appropriate for the situation. For example, in FIRST, you might need to ask questions like, what wheelbase will we use? How should we create a lifting mechanism? How can we grab these cones reliably? And amazingly, you can see how every team has created their own unique ways to answer these questions. Now look at the robots that competed in the XPRIZE competition I was a part of. Every single robot is unique and has radically different approaches to the challenge of transporting someone's presence. Every team had to tackle issues with robot reliability, mechanical stability, and good driving to attempt to win, much like in FIRST. Creativity is another skill you are learning through FIRST that can help you in various careers. In engineering, the design process often requires creativity to dream up new solutions. The inspiration for these ideas can come from many sources and can be brilliant breakthroughs or more often derivations of other ideas. For this year's FTC challenge, maybe you saw a video of an automatic traffic cone collector and modified it. Or maybe you saw videos of mechanisms from VEX teams and adapted it for Go Build It. Or maybe you just had a great riff on a teammate's idea for aiming the cone towards a pole. The ability to come up with these insights and choose the best one has been instrumental in my career so far. For XPRIZE, I had to design a custom robot gripper from scratch using Professor Peter Whitney's actuator technology. To do it, I used inspiration from past robot gripper white papers, YouTube videos of linkage mechanisms, and lots of discussions and drawings with peers. As you can see, the creative process I had to go through is very similar to what you all do to create these incredible robots. I also want to talk about leadership and communication skills, of which FIRST was instrumental in helping me develop. You all have probably had to convince the rest of your team of an idea or explain why you chose a certain design to judges. This is excellent practice for conveying your ideas and gives you confidence to speak up for yourself. Countless times this has helped me to explain complex engineering topics to job recruiters, fellow team members, and even clients. Being able to express your ideas well is an invaluable skill that gets you further than you might expect. In fact, I was entrusted to demo our full Avatar XPRIZE system every time there were VIPs in the Northeastern lab because of my ability to explain the complex system. I even showed the system to the Lieutenant Governor of Massachusetts. Beyond professional skills, FIRST has been an amazing way for me to develop friendships that I expect to stay for the rest of my life. Right now, one of my roommates at Northeastern is Rob, who competed with me on the Brainstormers. Another close friend of mine is TJ from Canton Robodogs, who I am doing my final capstone project with. Also, when I was visiting colleges, I was given personal tours of both University of Michigan and Cornell from fellow competitors in FTC. This unique network of FIRST alumni has been a great group of people to stay in touch with, and results from gracious professionalism and respect for your peers. I want to end by talking about failure. During my time in FTC, we had countless failures from electronics blowing up to mechanisms tearing themselves apart. This taught me to plan for failure, recover from it, and learn from it. The night before our prize-winning run at the XPRIZE competition, our team was burning the midnight oil to ensure everything was set for the next day. Just 30 minutes before the venue closed for the night, our motors started melting because of a last-minute software change. Rather than throwing up our hands, we created a game plan for the next day and replaced the motors at 6 a.m. to make sure we were ready to run. Without my FIRST experience, I wouldn't have had the forethought to have extra motor modules ready for the competition, nor would I have had the grit to get them fixed in time. I hope you all can see how incredibly valuable this experience is and how it applies to real-world engineering. FIRST helped shape me as an engineer, and I can't wait to see what you all do in the future. Again, congratulations for making it to the Massachusetts State Championship, and good luck to you all.